When you think of a stargazer, you probably think of this. Or this. Possibly her. Or even one of these. Well, in this case, you would be completely wrong. When I think of a stargazer, I think of one of these. Stargazer Cast Iron is a small company launched in 2015 in Cherry Hill, New Jersey. They have since relocated to Allentown, Pennsylvania as their business began to grow and take off. You can visit their website at stargazercastiron.com or click the link below. I ordered the pan during the Christmas rush and was told ahead of time that they would ship it out soon after the holidays, which I found completely understandable, and true to their word, the pan arrived at my door during the first week of January. It came packaged adequately, wrapped in plastic, and in a cardboard box. The first thing I noticed is that it's a very handsome and modern looking skillet, unlike any other cast iron piece I'd seen. Unlike a lot of inexpensive cast iron cookware, which tends to have a gritty or coarse feeling along the bottom, the Stargazer skillet is extremely smooth, which is supposed to aid in what I'll call the non-stick qualities that a good cast iron pan can attain. Next, where most cast iron skillets have pour spouts on the sides, the Stargazer has gone instead with a flared rim which allows you to pour from anywhere or any angle. This is a fantastic idea and works quite well. Another item I noticed right away was the longer curved forked handle. Again, looking like modern high-end cookware, the longer handle, forked at the end, helps to keep it cooler for a longer period of time. You might still want to use a pot holder or an oven mitt to pick it up if it's been on a hot stove for a while or in the oven, but it really doesn't heat up as fast as my shorter, unforked lodge handles do. The handle, like most cast iron skillets, has a hanger hole so you can hang it on your wall, on a pegboard, or from any hook that you'd like to put it on. And the back of the pan is quite attractive as well. Now, this is my own personal opinion, but I think the Stargazer logo is very sharp. It makes me think of some mid-century modern designs. I don't know if that's what they were going for, but it's cool. It also has a Made in the USA stamp on the back, which if you've seen any of my videos, you know I love seeing that. Something else to notice is they actually have the date the pan was cast stamped on the helper handle, so you can celebrate its birthday every year if you're that kind of person. You can get these pans either bare or already seasoned for a few dollars more. I decided to play it safe and get the already seasoned model. They do state that they use two thin coats of seasoning and that you may want to season it further in order to fully appreciate its potential for non-stick qualities. Now, as I said before, the pans are made right here in the USA. What's also important to note is that all of the materials are sourced right in the USA. In addition, all of their packaging is made from recycled materials that are also sourced right here in the USA. So they're doing the best that they can to keep all of the money here with jobs and whatnot that it takes to get these materials, as well as making as minimal an effect as possible on the environment. The more I research these guys, the more I like them. I decided that I would see how well their seasoning worked, so I jumped right into the deep end with some scrambled eggs. Now, they do recommend using extra oil or butter when you first start using the pan, so I played fair and did so, but not a whole lot extra. And I was impressed. The eggs didn't do a lot of sticking and came out quite well. Now, I'm no master chef, and you might not like the way I prepare my eggs, but you're not eating them, I am, and I like them. Will I do some more seasoning on the pan? Yeah, I think a few more coats would certainly make it even better. If you're brand new to cast iron, they do include a short pamphlet giving you some suggestions and advice on the cleaning, cooking, and seasoning processes that you might want to use. Another thing to note, they list the skillet as a 10.5 inch, but you actually have about 8 to 8.5 inches of cooking surface. They're measuring the top portion of the skillet from one end to the other, and this is typically done by all manufacturers. My pan weighed in at about 5 pounds, 5 ounces. A comparable lodge that I have weighed in at about 4 pounds, 7 ounces. I'm thinking a lot of the weight difference is probably in the much larger handle of the Stargazer. So at the end of the day, what do I think of the Stargazer 10 and a half inch skillet? I think it's great. I think that they have taken a classic cooking vessel and added modern and innovative features that make it a better product. They also do it in the right way. They manufacture it in the USA, and they have all their parts and materials sourced from the USA, including their packaging. From what I understand, they are planning on more products in the future. They do have on their website right now, they're advertising a 12-inch skillet, but they're also planning on making things like woks and Dutch ovens. And if you have a suggestion, I think they're open to that as well. So if you wanted to contact them and you had an idea, they'd love to hear it. I hope you enjoyed my review. I hope you found it helpful. If you did, please feel free to comment below, hit the like button, or even better yet, subscribe. That way I can continue doing these. I do have more in the working stages right now, and I'm planning on getting those out pretty soon. But until then, have a great life, and I'll see you next time.